Hey, I'm Doug. Welcome to Backcountry Pilgrim, a channel devoted to backpacking, hiking, and the Camino de Santiago. Today, we're going to be talking about how to get your stuff through airport security and maybe, just maybe, back home. When it comes to how you're going to travel, there are at least three barriers that are going to keep you from getting your stuff, and that is the airline, the airport, and the TSA agent. Different airlines have different rules about the size of baggage or the weight of the baggage that you can bring with you on the plane should you choose to try to bring everything on carry-on so that you don't stand any chance of losing it. Different airports have different rules about what you're allowed to bring with you on carry-on. Not necessarily so much the size, but what the object actually is. And typically this has to do with security. And then finally, if you're from America at least, we have an entire other agency called the TSA that handles security for the airports, and they have their own set of rules. But even if you know what those rules are, any given agent can just make a call right there with you in line. So these are just general guidelines, things that have worked, things that might work, and none of these guidelines are foolproof. All right, first let's talk about airlines and baggage size. If you are really committed to the idea of just bringing everything on carry-on, checking nothing, then you really just need to get a backpack that is small enough to do the carry-on thing on your plane. So for example, this bag measures 32 inches by 15 by 15. This is about 19 by 12 by 6. In America, the average allowable size for a carry-on item, that's like the one thing you can put in the overhead bin, is 22 by 14 by 9 inches. In non-American flights, the numbers are a little bit different. The average that I have seen is 21.7 by 15.7 by 9. So again, it's very important to realize that what might work on your flight to Europe might not work on your way back. Now, if you're bringing a backpack that is not going to fit on carry-on, I would still be concerned about checking that bag. And the reason is that the kind of thing that a backpack is just not the sort of thing that most airlines are set up to handle very well. If you think about typical luggage, what is it? It's a big rectangular block, right? With very little sticking out, nothing hanging off of it. That's pretty much the opposite of your typical backpack. I mean, there's straps, 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 pocket, 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 toggle, toggles. Everything that's holding this backpack together on here has a chance of slipping in between some rollers or getting bound up somehow and torn up pretty bad. So even if you're not all that concerned about the airline simply losing your stuff, it could still get destroyed while you're trying to put it on the plane. Bringing a duffel bag big enough to put the pack in might be a good idea. Just basically pack your duffel bag in your pack. Open the pack, get out the duffel, and you're good to go. Now, what happens if you have a pack that's too big for carry-on, but you still don't want to check it at the airport? Keep in mind that in most airports, you really have three different phases. You have your check-in stage where you deal with your tickets and you check your bags if you need to. In most airports today, you can just skip this part and go straight into airport security. Now, airport security is all about what is in your bag, which we'll talk about in a minute. They don't care how big it is. All they want to do is decide if you are safe to get into the airport. So, if you walk into security with a bag that is too big for carry-on, security is not going to say anything about it. What this means is that you can get all the way to stage three, the actual gate, with a pack that is too big to carry on. If you walk up to the gate agent and say, "Hey, I think my bag might be too big for carry on. Can you check?" They will happily measure the bag and be happy to tell you, "No, sorry, you can't bring this on carry-on." And that is when you get to gate check it. A gate check is completely different than an airline check. In an airport check, you could literally be a mile away from the plane that you're trying to get on, and you're handing your baggage over, which will be unloaded at the next airport you go to, unless you have a connecting flight, in which maybe it gets lost there. But even if it makes it to the final airport, then it has to go backwards through the nightmarish process until you finally see that thing come out on the track. In a gate check, what they do is actually take your item and just put it right into a special storage area of the plane. And when that plane lands and you exit, your stuff is waiting for you right there at the gate. If all of this is stressing you out, then your best bet is to simply take a pack that will definitely fit on carry-on, and just don't bring anything with you on your flight that is going to be considered a security risk. Now, because you can typically get past that first stage of the airport where you're just doing ticketing and baggage check and just go straight into security, one of your primary concerns needs to be what is in your pack and not just how big the pack is. There are a number of items that the security stage is not going to let you get through if you have your stuff. And this is something you definitely want to plan ahead for, because if you get up to the security stage, one of two things is going to happen. They're either going to turn you around, march you all the way back to stage one, where now you've got to stand in line there and then stand in line again at security, which could make you late for your plane. Or they're just going to say, you can't take this on the plane, and they will happily sell it on eBay for you. I mean, throw it away for you. So if you're a person who's used to hiking with a neck knife, or even just like a regular little Swiss Army pocket knife, that is something you are not going to be allowed to bring on the plane with you on carry-on, even if it's a very small one. The other item that seems to cause a big problem is trekking poles. They have a somewhat sharp tip. And for the American TSA and the European security agencies that I have heard about, these are considered too dangerous to bring on carry-on. This could cause an especially big problem if you try it and you get all the way up to security and they take them away from you. This means you're going to lose your trekking poles. So what that means is that your safest bet on trekking poles is to just assume that you are not going to get them on carry-on. Now, if you're going to airport check them, you can't just hand them to the agent and say, here, check these for me. Best bet would be a bag. Personally, I'd cut all this junk off. Nice tight package, maybe tape up the end. Here you go. Here's my trekking poles. The other nice thing about a bag like this is that you can put in other things. So, here's my neck knife. Drop that in there. Pocket knife. Drop that in there. Tactical spork. Drop that in there. You're basically just making yourself a very compact, minimalistic package that you can check before you get to security, who will take it all away. If you're going with more than one person, maybe try to get all of your stuff into a single bag so that you're only checking one thing. A lot of airlines now are charging for anything over your carry-on. I've seen it up around 50 euros in Europe. Now, the poles I'm interested in bringing are very reasonably priced. Paying 50 euro to check those poles and bring them back to America with me would actually cost more than just donating them and buying new ones when I got home. However, if you're one of those black diamond cork carbons upwards of $150, $200 on a pair of trekking poles, that might be worth going ahead and dealing with the check-in price to get them back. One final piece of advice, no matter what you do, have a little day pack, fanny pack, something with you that has the stuff you're going to want on the plane, so that whether your stuff gets taken, whether it gets airport checked, whether it gets gate checked, you still have your essentials for the flight with you at all times. All right, I hope this video has been helpful for you. If it has, would you mind clicking like and consider subscribing to the channel so that you can get more backpacking, hiking, Camino advice, gear reviews. You aren't going to be notified of any new videos unless you also click the bell. Buen Camino.